Hello friends, welcome to GT Science Tutorial. In this video, I'm going to explain about expansion work in irreversible adiabatic process. This is one of the very important theories in thermodynamics that helps us to study the expansion behavior of ideal gas under adiabatic condition. So in this video, we are going to derive the mathematical formulation of this theory, as well as we are going to compare the work done in adiabatic process and work done in isothermal process. So let's start. In irreversible adiabatic process, the following two cases are possible. The first one is free expansion. In free expansion, the gas expands against zero pressure, that is in vacuum. Let me write that. In this case, the gas expands against zero pressure, that is in vacuum. And if the gas is expanding in vacuum, then obviously it doesn't have to do any work. So in this particular case, the work done is equal to zero. So this is the first case in vacuum. That is, in vacuum, the gas do not have to do any work and it expands freely without doing any work. Now another case is intermediate expansion. Intermediate expansion. In this case, the gas has to expand against some pressure, some external pressure. For this, let me draw a diagram. This is very important diagram. Let us consider there is a cylinder like this, which is fitted with weightless and frictionless piston. The piston, an ideal gas is kept in it. An ideal gas is kept in it, and let us consider the pressure to be P1 and the volume is V1. Now, if the gas is expanding, then obviously the piston will go up here. This is now the new position of the piston, right? And the pressure reduces and the volume increases. Volume becomes V2 and the pressure reduces to P2, which is equal to P external pressure. That is, whatever is the external pressure, the new pressure will be equal to that. And we are considering that external pressure or the new pressure to be P2. Okay, so this is the figure that we need to consider. Let me write the caption for it. Adiabatic expansion. Adiabatic expansion. So look at here, let me write little bit. In this case, the gas expands against some pressure and that is equal to P1. And the initial volume is V1. The new pressure is P2, that is equal to P external pressure, and the new volume is V2, such that P1 is greater than P2. Obviously, in this initial condition, the gas was in compressed form. So obviously, the first pressure, that is the initial pressure P1, was greater. And now, as the gas has expanded, then obviously the pressure will decrease. So P1 is greater than P2. Now, as the gas has already expanded, see, this is irreversible process. In irreversible process, the gas expands suddenly. Okay, and that process is very quick. And that in that particular case, P1 will directly reduce to P2. Now the gas will expand against the new external pressure P2 only, right? Now the gas expands against new pressure, and that is P2, right? Then the work done will be against pressure P2. So the work done, that is WIRR, will be given to how much? What is the formula of work done? Yes, you are thinking correct. It is the product of pressure and change in volume, right? What is the pressure now? P2. So we'll put P2 over here into. What is the change in volume? Obviously, greater volume V2 minus smaller volume V1. So it will be V2 minus V1. Let us consider this to be question number 1. Now for further calculation, let me erase this portion. As we are considering ideal gas, so we can put ideal gas equation over here. According to ideal gas equation, what is the ideal gas equation? Yeah, you are thinking correct. PV is equal to nRT. Let's find the value of V from here. So V will be equal to nRT by P. Similarly, let's find the value of V1. V1 will be equal to nRT1 by P1, and V2 will be equal to nRT2 by P2. So using these values in equation 1, using the values of V1 and V2 in equation 1, then what do we get? Let's see that WIRR will be equal to P2 nRT2 by P2 minus nRT1 by P1. We get this much. Let's multiply these two terms by P2, then P2 will get cancelled out. So it will be nRT2 minus nRT1 and then P2 by P1, right? N is common among them. So let's take N to be common, RT2 minus RT1 P2 by P1. I have not taken R to be common because this N will be cancelled out later on. Okay, so this is equation number 2. Again, we know that there is another formula of work done for ideal gas. Okay, that is WIRR is equal to nCV T1 minus T2. This is another formula that is used to calculate the work done in irreversible process. Okay, and this is the formula that we use to calculate the exact value. Okay. From this sieve, this N is a constant, CV we can know, this T1 we can know in the initial case, but we just need to find out the value of T2, okay, in terms of some values that we can calculate, okay. So we are trying to find out the value of T2 by solving these equations, so that we can put the value of T2 over here, so that we can find the value of WIRR. Here, this is also WIRR, this is also WIRR, so we can equate them. So equating equation 2 and 3. So what do we get? Look at here, this can be written as nCV T1 minus T2 equals to, we can put this value, nRT2 minus RT1 P2 by P1. Right, so we get this much, and N will be cancelled out. Now we can write CV T1 minus CV T2 equals to RT2 minus RT1 P2 by P1. Right, let's take this value to this side and this value to that side. So what do we get? We get CV T1 plus RT1 P2 by P1. Equals to RT2 plus CVT2, right? So we get this much. Now what is the common here and here? CV plus R P2 by P1 into T1
because T1 is common between these two terms, and here T2 is common. So it will be R plus CV into T2. And if we find the value of T2, we just have to take this value to this side. So therefore, T2 will be equal to how much? Yes, CV plus R P2 by P1 by R plus CV whole multiplied by T1. So this is the formula of final temperature. Okay, now by using the value of T2 from equation 4, in equation 3, we can find the value of work done in irreversible process. Let me write over here. The value of T2 can be calculated from equation 4, and it can be used in 3 to get the value of work done. So this is the complete derivation for work done in irreversible adiabatic process. For that, we need the final temperature T2 that we can obtain from this value. And if we put the value of T2 in equation 3, that is WIRR is equal to NCV T1 minus T2, then we can get a specific value of WIRR. Now let's compare the work done in adiabatic process and work done in isothermal process. We are going to do the comparison of isothermal and adiabatic expansion by graphical method. But before that, we need to know two things. For adiabatic process, we can draw a conclusion that is PV gamma is a constant. So the product of P and V to the power gamma is a constant, and it can be written as P proportional to 1 by V to the power gamma, or you can simply say P is inversely proportional to V to the power gamma. Let's consider it to be equation number 1. Similarly, for isothermal process, another conclusion can be drawn, that is PV is equal to constant, that is the product of pressure and volume is constant in case of isothermal process, and we can write P proportional 1 by V, that is pressure is inversely proportional to the volume, right? So these are the two cases for adiabatic and isothermal process. Now let me draw a graph, that is pressure volume graph, for both of them. The pressure volume graph for isothermal and adiabatic process is like this. In y-axis, we need to consider pressure. In x-axis, we need to consider volume, right? So this is the initial condition. This is initial condition. The pressure volume curve for isothermal process is like this. That is, as the volume increases, the pressure decreases. But on the other hand, the pressure volume work of the pressure volume curve for adiabatic process is like this, that is, it is more steeper than that one. This is for isothermal process, and we know that for isothermal process the change in internal energy is zero and the change in temperature is also zero, and this is for adiabatic process. And for adiabatic process, the change in heat energy will be zero. That is, there won't be any exchange of heat energy between the system and surrounding in case of adiabatic process. So these are the two curves that we get if we plot pressure against volume for isothermal and adiabatic process. For isothermal process, the change in internal energy of the system will be zero. Similarly, the temperature change will also be zero. But in case of adiabatic process, temperature must change. The temperature changes, but only the heat energy between the system and the surrounding is zero. We can see here the curve of adiabatic process is steeper than the curve of isothermal process. The reason for that is, in isothermal process, there will be the exchange of heat energy between the system and surrounding. While expansion, the gas needs some energy or heat energy that it gets from the surrounding. Surrounding will provide it the heat energy that it needs for the expansion. But in case of adiabatic process, it can't get the energy from outside. It has to use its own internal energy in order to expand. Let's write this. Let me write over here. In isothermal process, the system gets heat energy from surrounding to expand. But in case of adiabatic process, the system can't get heat and has to use its own internal energy in order to expand. And this is the reason why the adiabatic curve is steeper than the isothermal curve, as well as also it is observed that the drop in pressure in case of adiabatic process is greater than isothermal process for same volume of gas. That is, you can see from graph over here, the drop in pressure for adiabatic process is obviously greater than in isothermal process if we take the same volume of gas. For same volume, the pressure change will be greater than in adiabatic process than in isothermal process. This is the graph that we get if we plot pressure against volume in these two processes. And we know that the work done simply is the area of pressure volume curve. That is, this area is for isothermal process and this much area is for adiabatic process. Then you can compare by yourself as well. The area of this whole region, that is for isothermal process, is greater than the area of adiabatic process. Then obviously the work done in isothermal process is greater than that in adiabatic process. Hence, the work done in adiabatic process is less than that of isothermal process. So by this graphical method, we compared the work done in adiabatic expansion and isothermal expansion. That is, isothermal expansion requires more work done. That's all in this video. I hope you understood everything about this video. If you like the video, please share this video as much as you can. And thank you for watching the video.